सेटिंग में जाके हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू द यूट्यूब चैनल साइंटिया वर्ल्ड. टुडे वी आर गो आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द टॉपिक ऑफ केमिकल काइनेटिक्स. वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रिएक्शन, सेकेंड ऑर्डर केमिकल रिएक्शन एंड nth ऑर्डर एंड zeroth ऑर्डर. एट लास्ट वी विल हैव ए समरी सो दैट वी कैन रिकॉल देम, रिमेंबर देम एवरी टाइम. ओके, सो आई विल शो यू हाउ the I'm going to explain you is here. At the last I'm going to have a summary through which you can remember and you can solve your problems properly. This is a summary. As you can see, we need to remember rate constant and then half life time of all the reactions, first order, second order, zero order and then nth order. As you know, if you know the nth order, you can substitute here 0, 1, 2, you can find out all the rate constants and as well as this half life also. Okay, so let's start. You spend your time listen to the derivations carefully so that if you forget the formulas, you can directly substitute the values in the reactions and derivation. You'll be able to derivation properly after listening it. After listening a first order reaction, even you will be able to write second order reaction derivation and zero order reaction derivation as well as nth order reaction without any problem. Okay, so let's start. Once you should know what is rate. Rate is nothing but dx by dt. Dx by dt means what? Concentration with respect to time. Okay, so I'll start. I'm telling you that R is a rate constant. I'm representing it as a rate constant. Minus d, here I am representing minus. It shows decrease in the concentration of reactant. And if we write about product, it increase in rate of constant. So first order reaction, I have written a definition so that you can write in exams as well. If you write like this, it's completely right. Okay, in exams, first order chemical reaction, the rate of the reaction is directly proportional. It means the rate of the reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of the reactant to the power 1. Okay, here power 1, to the power 1. If you write zero order reaction, to the power 0. If you write for the rate of the reaction for second order, to the power 2. For nth, you will write here n. Okay, I am taking a equation and reaction from A is a reactant. I am getting the product B. At a time 0, my reactant concentration was A naught and product concentration was 0, and then at time t I got the concentration of product is x, means we will minus from the reactant. Okay, concentration of reactant, that is A naught minus x. With respect to reactant, we are going to derive first order reaction. Okay, as I said to you that rate of the reaction is directly proportional to the concentration to the power 1. How we will write the rate dx by dt, as I said, and we know that the concentration of the reactant increases as we go on getting the product B. So we will represent it with minus charge. dA by dt equals to k1. As we removed the proportionality constant from here, we will write k1. K1 is rate constant. Okay. And now from a0 to a0 minus x, I am writing integration a0 to a0 minus x. Here I have substituted dt will go this side. I am in the right side and a will come here left side. As you know, concentration time from 0 to t, 0 to t I have represented. As I will tell you here, you should know the integration formulas. 1 by x integration 1 by x dx will be equals to ln x. So 1 by a power 1, it means a, and dx you will get minus, you will write as usual ln a naught to a naught minus x k1. Here I have integrated, so t 0 to t. Okay, now upper value minus lower value. and then you should know here a logarithm formula, that ln a minus ln b means ln a by b you can write. So ln a naught minus x by a naught, here minus to remove negative charge, I will reverse them. I'll get ln a naught by a naught minus x k1t. I will send this t here, it will go in a division. So 1 by t ln of a naught by a naught minus x equals to k1. Now to remove ln, I will keep ln equals to 2.303 log. In logarithm I need. So 2.303 by t log a naught by a naught minus x equals to k1. This is the rate constant value for the first order reaction. Okay, now we will do for similarly, we can do for second order reaction also. We should know your integration formulas. And I said you that the concentration here, I'll show you. You'll see this one later. For second order, rate of the reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of the reactant to the power 2. Proportionality constant removed, K2, concentration of A to the power 2. With respect to product, similarly here I have taken A minus X. Now here concentration of the reactant decreasing. So D of A by dt K2 A concentration of A square integrated from A to A minus X. 0 to t. Okay, 0 to t. Here, I already said you that you need to know the formulas of integration. So, integration 1 by x square dx value I am getting minus 1 by x. Here I have used the formula integration x power n dx equals to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Okay, minus 2 I got. If I take it reverse up, minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1. X inverse by minus 1, I will write minus 1 by x. As usual, you can write here also. And minus 1 by a I concentration a I got a to a minus x limits k to t, that is 0 to t limits. Now minus into minus plus I have done. Now 1 by a minus x, 1 by a, substituted this a with this value. Okay, k to t, 1 by t here I substitute. This is rate constant for second order reaction. Okay, you got how you can do this. Now we will go for the now we will see an half life for first and second order reactions. Okay, as you need to remember, I'll tell you one thing that you need to remember, the rate constants, then you can easily get the value for the half life. Okay, so this is 2.3, this is a rate constant. Here what concentration you have taken, you have taken that a to b at 0 time a naught and at time t a naught minus x. Now for half life, what we will do is we will take for at 0 a naught, and for half life we will take, means concentration became half a naught by t, and with respect to reactant we are doing. So you can substitute the values at the place of a naught and a naught minus x. A naught by a naught minus x, we have a naught by 2, we have substituted log 2 value, multiplying with 2.303 we are getting 0.693 by k1. This is the half life for first order reaction. To get unit for rate constant of first order reaction, we have seen, here there was time. I'll show you. This is time. This is a concentration. Concentration get cancelled and we got second universe as a unit. Okay, I think you understood this. Now, half life for second order reaction. For second order half life, similarly we will take a by 2. In the formula of second order rate constant, we will substitute. Here will be a, at the place of a minus x we have a by 2, we will substitute it here. Now with mathematical you can do this, a goes up, 2 minus 1 by a means 1 by a, and half life will be of life equals to 1 by k a k2 k2 is nothing but second order rate constant. Okay, now I think you got for first order as well as second order. Now we will see for zero order reaction. Similar, same, you can write definition that rate of the reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of the reactant to the power zero. Now for removing a proportionality constant, we will write rate constant and concentration A naught. If this is the reaction we have taken, that from A reactant we will get the B product. At zero time we had A and at time t we had A minus x. Now we will write rate of the reaction, means we will write dx by dt. Here we are having reactant A minus, it means decreasing in the concentration of the reactant, dA by dt equals to k naught A. We'll substitute, we will bring this one here and this one here. Okay, so what we will do is minus will be there, A power 0 equals to 1, so it became 1, dA will become A. Okay, integration dx equals to x. Similarly, here we will get integration d concentration A means concentration A. Minus will be there. Limits A to A minus x we are having. I'll show you again. If you are not understanding, we'll do it. Okay, this is A minus x at a time t. So minus will be there, A minus x minus A. As we can substitute here, A we can write minus into minus plus A minus A minus x. This is at time t concentration, this is at time zero concentration. This is the rate constant for zero order chemical reaction. And for half life, what you will do at the place of A minus x, at half life time we are going to have A by 2. Okay, we'll substitute there A by 2. See, A and at a half lifetime, A by 2, A minus A by 2, T half life. Now, as mathematically you can do, you will get A by 2, T half, and T half lifetime, that is A by 2 K naught. This is half life for half lifetime of zero order chemical reaction. And for rate constant, we had here concentration. This is concentration. A is concentration. A minus x is also concentration. This is at time 0. This is at time t. Means concentration by time. Concentration is nothing but molarity. Molarity is nothing but moles. Number of moles present in a liter of solution. So mole, liter universe by second. That is mole, liter universe, second universe. Okay, this is as we have done zero order reaction also. Now we will go through the nth order chemical reaction. Here the rate of the reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of the reactant to the power n. Okay, we will substitute here power n. I have told you in starting also that how we are going to derive. After first order, you are able to do it. But once we should go through, so that you should not have any doubt. Now, what we are going to do is here. Similarly, we will take here also. At time t we had zero A naught concentration, B is 0. At time t, A naught minus x, and the concentration of B is x. Minus dA by dt kn, that is rate constant at the nth order, concentration A power n. Now we have substituted this one here and this one here. So I have done here x power minus n plus 1 by minus n plus 1. Similarly, we will write here also. And then at last, what we will do, you can do it mathematically. Okay, you just see it, pause the video, and you can take screenshot as well. Minus n plus 1, minus n plus 1 to power, you will substitute this, we'll get 1 minus n. Here also 1 minus n I have written. From A naught to A naught minus x, and then what I have done is I have taken this outside 1 by minus 1 plus n. So n minus 1, 1 by, if it is in the numerator 1 minus n, when it goes to denominator it will become n minus 1. Okay, reverse. and then I have substituted the values. This T has came here in the multiplication with it, and then at a concentration, from upper limit we will do lower limit, okay? And or this is 1 by n minus 1 into T whole 1 by a naught minus x power n minus 1 minus 1 by a naught power n minus 1 equals to kn is a rate constant for the nth order reaction. Okay, and now I'll give you a small tip that this is a formula you can use for other reactions also for finding a rate constant. If you want for zero order, substitute here zero. For first order, substitute the place of n 1. Okay, you will get rate constants for other reactions as well. Remember this formula: mole power 1 minus n liter power n minus 1 time inverse. And for half life, we'll do similarly. We will substitute here a by 2. At that T half we have taken n minus 1 T half in the bracket 1 by a naught by 2 n power n minus 1 minus 1 by a naught power n minus 1. Now this kn comes here and T half, because we want T half life, okay, means half lifetime. Now this 2 goes up, 2 having 2 to the power of n minus 1 here minus 1, a naught power n minus 1 in the denominator, here also a naught power n minus 1. So we can write here 2 power n minus 1 minus 1 by a naught power n minus 1. Okay, this is a half lifetime for nth order reaction. You need to remember this also, and this is the summary that you need to remember. Okay, and you can write T half is inversely proportional to a power n minus 1. Okay, you can take this all as a constant, and 1 by a naught power n minus 1 T half lifetime will be that. I hope you liked this content, and if you like the video, thank you so much for sparing your time on this video, and we'll meet again. Thank you, bye.